afternoon, guys. Kenny here at Brave the Wilds. So, out here today in the driveway, we're going to do another project for the hut. And this will be chapter of the hut 13, I think. And today we're going to build a kitchen island slash work table. Basically, we're going to have a sink on the right and a metal working surface on the left so we can put down hot stuff. And also, we can clean it off easy so that way, because wood will sometimes, you know, kind of trap the bacteria and stuff in your food. So you want something that you can really clean up, so metal will be a good option. I've got a piece right here. So I've just got some scrap wood, and so I'm going to go ahead and grab that and bring that up here. And so right now I'm only limited to non-power tools, or I can't use the chop saw until my parents get home. So I'll have to wait for that, but I can start using my handsaw to do a little bit of the work. So let me go and get everything set up and we'll get started. Alright, so we went ahead and got most of our wood out there. So we can go ahead and start cutting here shortly. Let me go ahead and show you guys. Get this camera and this tripod. Let me show you guys my plan. Bring this up just a little bit. The idea is a very simple cabinet style. And I tried to do a little bit of 3D drawing here. Not sure it's quite the right. I don't think I did a great job, but it's okay. So we're just going to have side pieces. These probably won't be panels. These will probably end up being 2x4 legs, and same with the back. So these are just to kind of give you an idea of what the size is, so I have an idea for myself as well. So we've got our metal cutting board up here, and I do believe that's 24 inches by 20 inches. And then we've got a bucket over here that we're going to use as a sink. And then the whole thing's going to be 37 inches wide, 22 inches deep, and 36 inches tall. So that's the idea. And I already went down to the hut to verify to make sure everything's going to fit properly. I'm not sure the dimension of the new stove I'm getting, considering I have no idea what my source is going to be. I've called around. No one's seemed like they want to donate one to the project. So it looks like I'm going to have to make one for myself, because paying for it's not really an option right now, considering it's so expensive. So let me go and get some things set up, and we'll go ahead and start cutting. Alright, so our first cuts are two of them at 19 inches. And these are going to be our side 2x4s on these sides. I know it's a bit hard to visualize now, but you'll get the hang of it. Alright guys, well, I finished cutting everything. I didn't want to bore you with showing a bunch of that. I think most people know how to use power tools. So I'm going to go ahead and assemble this for you and we'll pretty much be done. Keep in mind, the middle of this is supposed to be completely empty. I'm not going to do any shelves or anything like that because I want to use this area under here for stove firewood. I've got a firewood section designated for the fireplace, but all the stove wood I have is smaller, so it fits in my stoves. I need that to be in a separate area. I don't have a spot for that now, so that'll go under here. I've got plenty of shelves. I think I counted last time. I have like 19 shelves, so I've got plenty of those. So this needs to mainly be for firewood. And the good thing about having a wood floor in there, hopefully sometime soon I'll get that video out to you. It's going to take a while to get it done, but I'll try and get it out to you, you know, definitely before the end of summer. But the good thing about having the wood floor is I can actually screw this down to the floor once I finish building it, and that'll make it rock solid. So let's go and start assembling. The front piece, I have a thinner piece right here, so that way it's not as big, so you have more room to put stuff like, you know, the stove wood and that kind of thing. So in order to compensate for that, I had to put a notch in these first legs. So I just did that with the handsaw and then chisel, or basically just baton down that little section to create a notch. Very simple. And I'm definitely going to pre-drill for all of this because it is very prone to splitting out. And I'm just using 3-inch deck screws for the bigger stuff and 2-inch screws for the smaller stuff. A little bit of an awkward angle. Get around here. Thank you. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we've got our two legs done here. We're going to take one last piece of 2x4. Actually, this looks like 2x3. And we're going to do a stretcher across the back, a little bit of an angle, and that'll help secure it this way and keep it from racking. So, first thing we need to do is we need to figure out where we want it. Right there looks about good. So now I can actually take my pencil and just mark those angles and go over and cut them. Alright, we just got that last piece in, and that's really going to help keep everything from racking. So now, let me make sure this camera can see everything. Looks like it. It's not going to be a light table, that's for sure. Driveway's not very level, but should be able to make it work. So, not the prettiest looking thing in the planet, but it'll do the job. There's an overhang right there for a reason, don't worry. But a little bit of joint work right there, not the prettiest. Same thing over here. But all in all, it'll do the job. It's going in the hut, so it's not a huge deal. But that way I can have a good tall work table. I'm tired of working on stuff really down low. So now I can have a nice tall work table with a sink as well. And then I can also put firewood in underneath. So, let's go ahead and figure out a way to put the sink in. Alright, so here's our bucket that we're going to use as our sink. So the first thing we need to do is pop off these wire handles. And so I'm going to position it up front. Sorry if the camera's shaking. I'm going to position it up front so I have enough room to put some kind of water storage device and a spigot. So that way it doesn't take up any room on the wall that I have to. I can just actually use the table to do it. So there's my hole to drill out right here. Doesn't look like it's in the way of anything. I'm not going to hit a 2x4. So I can go ahead and drill a hole into it and grab a jigsaw. And I can start to drill out or cut out this hole. So let's do that next. Wow, was that not a good circle. Alright, looks like I got a little bit more takeoff here and a little bit more all the way around the edges. There we go. Sweet. It's kind of binded it in a few areas to where it doesn't look like a perfect circle, but that's perfectly fine with me. That's not a big deal to me. So, we've got our sink, but what we don't have is a drainage hole, obviously, to let the water go. So that's the next step, and I may save that to just do by myself and show you guys when I'm done, because this video is already running out a little bit long. I have no idea how much I'm going to edit it. But that looks pretty good so far, so that's pretty much all we can do for right now. I can work on a little bit of drainage system. And the next thing is to try and figure out how to get this piece of metal to attach to the tabletop. Now, normally you'd be like, well, Kenny just drill a hole. But unfortunately, the metal that I had to get is stainless steel. And in case any of you are unfamiliar with metals, stainless steel is extremely hard and it will destroy a bit.
Okay, guys, well, so we are done for the time being. Done about as much as we can for one day. Not my best work. I did a really, really crappy joint right here that made it not so sturdy with the leg right here. But that's okay because I can always screw it into the floor. It's not supposed to be pretty. It's supposed to be functional. And I definitely have achieved that. As you can see now, I've got a nice piece of stainless steel here for working. That way I can don't have to worry about cleanliness being a factor if I put it directly in the wood. And then later I go to put something on the wood again. I do have a fear that, you know, the bacteria and stuff like that on the earlier food could contaminate the later food. So as long as you clean this off some good 409, you shouldn't have to worry about that. And then I've got my sink right here, which is at its beginning stages, and it'll be finished up when it gets in the hut. But as you can see, pretty simple. Took longer than it should have, but that's okay. So I'm getting to the point now where I'm kind of working on getting everything cleaned up for the summertime. And one of my goals is to get my personal space completely cleaned up, and that includes the hut, getting it finished. Right now it's a wreck. I'm moving a bunch of things around. I have to take everything out to put the floor in. So once the floor gets in, this will be installed. And all the stove wood will be put underneath. As you can see, we've got tons of room for the stove wood underneath. And that was the main point. So it'll be nice and strong to hold all that. And it'll be a great area to cook and work at, because we'll have the stove next to it right here. And then the fireplace, or the firewood, and then the fireplace will be right here. So definitely got a good working area. It's a bit taller and a bit shallower than the table that I had in there temporarily. And that was the point. I needed something that didn't stick out as far as the first one did, and I need some a little bit wider, so this will suit my needs perfectly. So I appreciate you guys watching and commenting. It really means a lot to me. So I know you guys have been really asking for Chapter of the Hut 13. I've had so many comments asking if it's gone away. No, it's not gone away. The series, I'm still doing it. Just a little bit slower in the summertime, but definitely when fall picks up, we're going to be camping out a lot, practically living there. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you on the next video.